Are you so glad break's over?
Does it look like I'm glad?
I guess it doesn't help that it's Tech Week.
Please don't remind me.
Are you at least ready to anchor?
Totally. I'm Katie Garms.
And I'm Quinn Brewer,
And
and
you're
you're
watching
watching
Soho
Soho
TV.
TV.
Your mom and dad are doing fine. You guys are on my mind. You asked me what I wanted to be, and now I think the answer is plain to see.
Do you think I could be president?
If you were, I'd flee the country.
What? Why?
You can barely be president of the Safer Club.
Not true.
When was the last time we had a meeting?
It's been a rough couple months, okay?
Sure. Let's watch Travis's package about some real US presidents.
What's up, Southold? I'm going to be interviewing people about US presidents. I'm here with
Mr. Stark, beloved substitute teacher, Brady Woods.
And Lyndon Waring. Lindsay Zofino.
What is the minimum age to become a U.S. president?
35 years old.
Correct.
35 years old.
35. 40.
Who is the oldest president to ever serve?
Jimmy Carter.
Incorrect.
Biden.
George Washington. Abraham Lincoln.
Who is the only president to serve two terms but not win back-to-back elections?
Grover Cleveland.
Correct.
Oh, no.
Robert Wilson. Abraham Lincoln.
Who is the only president that gets stuck in the bathtub?
Taft.
Correct.
William Taft.
Donald Trump.
That one.
What's up, Southold? I'm going to be testing out some of our president's favorite foods. First thing we got is Obama's favorite, tortilla chips and guacamole. Let's test it out.
I'll give it a 5 out of 10.
Next up, we have George W. Bush's favorite, hamburger pizza with ketchup and mustard. Here we go.
Pretty good.
Give it out a 8 out of 10. Last, we have President Nixon's favorite, cottage cheese and ketchup. Here we go. Unfortunately, that's going to be a 0 out of 10. Don't try it. Before we end here, we have a little guest, Mark Stepanowski. He is going to be trying the cottage cheese and ketchup. Here we go.
That's pretty good, actually. This is yummy. I'm kidding. This is not bad. This is not bad.
Now you guys know about U.S. presidents, back to you in the studio.
I can't believe none of our president's favorite food was popcorn.
Maybe because that's a weird favorite food.
Whatever, at least my favorite food isn't sushi.
Excuse you? But sushi is so good. It's totally fetch.
There's no way you just said that.
Said what?
Fetch.
Yeah, it's slang from Mean Girls.
I'm in Mean Girls with you, Katie. And you couldn't make fetch happen in Mean Girls, so it's not gonna happen in the real world.
Whatever. Let's just watch this package I made about Southold's spring musical, Mean Girls.
I'm Quinn Brewer.
Hi, I'm Lila Zugmeyer.
I'm Emma Binkus.
Hi, my name is Jordani Chacon.
Hello, my name is Jocelyn Kalen.
And I'm playing Damian Hubbard.
And I'm playing Janice.
And I'm playing Karen Smith.
And I'm playing Regina George.
And I am playing Katie Heron in Mean Girls musical.
People should come see the show because Mean Girls is one of the greatest cinematic masterpieces of the century, if not all of time.
I think everyone should come see Mean Girls because the whole cast is so talented and we're all so into it and we work really hard to pull this off.
I think you guys should come see the show because we've worked really hard on it and it's a really fun show. If you are a fan of the movie, then you should come see the play.
I think the reason why people should come watch the show is because a lot of people put a lot of their work and effort and time and dedication So I suggest that you should come watch the show.
You should see the show because everyone's really good at acting and singing, and we all look really hot.
My favorite part of the play is when I'm forced to do a tap number for 5 minutes, except I can't tap.
In the play, I really love my part. I get to have so much fun with my character, and I can do a bunch of different fun things that I can't always do in my own life.
My favorite part of the show is definitely the song Sexy, because it's just, like, a lot of fun.
My favorite part is Sexy, starring Emma Binkus.
My favorite part to watch is Sexy, because Emma Binkus is amazing and the ensemble is so funny, and the dance is really good. And my favorite part to do is to sing Stupid with Love.
Come see Mean Girls March 7th, 8th, and 9th at 7 p.m. and March 10th at 2 p.m. Tickets are $12 for adults and $8 for students and seniors. Can't wait to see you there.
All that dancing makes me feel tired.
Me too. Almost as tired as basketball.
Speaking of sports, the Quiz Bowl team won another game.
Sport is a strong word.
Says who?
Me.
Next you're going to say esports aren't real sports either.
Well...
To prove you wrong, let's watch Brian Henry's package about Southfield's wildly successful esports team.
So, I think we've been playing our best games here at the end. We are playing an historic rookie season to make the state championship is remarkable. 37 teams set out for this goal. We're down to a final two.
Over the course of the past couple of weeks, the inaugural season of the esports team has been full of trials and tribulations, sound victories, and crushing defeats. But nonetheless, Southland has not just won, but both of its esports teams make a dash for the state title. Pitted brother against brother, Southhold White was able to beat Southhold Red to secure a second place spot and a chance at the state title. Unfortunately, that is where their dominant reign would end. Defeated in a grueling best of seven matchup against the state's concurrent champion, both Southhold teams would have to wait until the spring season for a second chance for a title run, ending the season 4th and 2nd in the state. A beautiful way to start Southhold's esports legacy.
The famous children author once said, "There are no happy endings, endings are the saddest part. So all you can ask for is a happy middle and a very happy start."
Being state finalists is pretty impressive.
See, I told you.
You know what? Let's watch a package about a real sport. One that takes the human body to its maximum potential.
Which sport?
A sport that requires skill, speed, agility, strength, and strategy.
Cheer? Is Dylan's cheer package next?
No. We're going to watch Travis's package about the most extreme sport ever created. Ping pong.
I'm here with...
Aiko.
Jack.
Judy.
Lauren.
Matthew McGonagall.
Nate Steinfeld. Kyan Olsen.
Emmett Tramontana.
What are your predictions for the game?
We're going to win.
Yeah, we're going to win.
I don't know. I feel like it'll be pretty even. I think we're going to win.
Loss.
I think we're going to lose first round. I think we're going to beat Nate because they're not good.
We're definitely going to win.
Who's the toughest opponent going to be?
I think Judy and Lauren.
Yeah, Judy and Lauren.
Probably Jack and Aiko.
Yeah, definitely Jack and Aiko.
Probably the first one that we verse. We're only going to play one game then lose, so probably the first match.
Probably Matt and Nate.
I'm going to go Jack and Aiko. Champions, how's it feel?
Number one in the world.
This is crazy. I've been waiting for this for so long. I mean, I'm at a loss.
How did it feel when you guys come in here and thought you were going to lose and you just won it all? How does it feel?
One piece of advice is just never give up.
The underdogs always win. The underdogs always win.
Wow, that was so intense.
I have goosebumps just from watching it.
Okay.
I was so invested in who was going to win.
Wow, it happened 2 weeks ago and it wasn't even close.
Shh.
Anyways, let's watch Dylan's package on cheerleading, something that's actually exciting.
Oh, didn't see you there. What's up, Southwood? It's Dylan
and Julia.
And here is Nationals 2024. boarding the plane.
Landed in Baltimore, now we're walking to our layover.
Flight 2.
Bus, now we're going to the hotel. We just got to the room and now we're going to practice. We just unpacked and yeah. We just finished practice and now we're going to dinner.
That's why you were running. Yeah.
We're all ready for bed. We practice tomorrow morning, so I'll see you guys in the morning.
Good night.
First practice, we're wearing our SPC tanks, white shorts, and our red bows.
Yay!
Practice with Riverhead, and now we're going back to lunch.
We're at practice 2.
Here's the outfit. So we just got ready for dinner, and now we're going to Disney Springs to eat. So we're watching Riverhead now. We got back from dinner, and then we're going to bed, and tomorrow's competition day. We're all ready, and now we're going to practice before competition.
We just competed, we did okay, 1 point in deductions, and now we're gonna see if we went through. We're at a
winner
right now.
Right. I'm so nervous. We're on our way to quarterfinals. We're about to do walkthroughs, and yeah, super excited.
We just hit, baby! We're finding out results, and we're super excited.
Day 3 semifinals, we compete at 11:22. Then we find out if we go through the finals at like 12-ish, and then we'll compete at 4 for finals.
We're going to finals.
Out of 90 teams, we ended up placing 25th in the nation, which was a huge accomplishment, and we made school history. Thank you for watching. Back to you in the studio.
You're right. That was really exciting.
I know, right? I wish I could do a backflip.
You just gotta put your mind to it.
The only way that would end is with my neck broken.
Hey, you'll never know till you try.
If you insist. If you don't hear from me tomorrow, you'll know what happened.
Well, anyways, this was Katie Garms.
And Quinn Brewer.
Thanks for watching Solo TV. Let's feel the rain on your